Hi everyone, and welcome to this virtual ST Developer Conference 2020. My name is Raffaele Riva, and I'm an application engineer on ultra-low power RF connectivity. With this short video, I would like to introduce you on how to use our latest Blue Energy -LP device in order to evaluate Bluetooth Low Energy coded PHY for increasing the range of your BLE-enabled application. If you are interested in more details, please keep watching.
Now I would like to introduce you on how to test the Bluetooth Low Energy coded PHY feature using our Blue Energy -LP device. Blue Energy -LP is our latest introduction among the Blue Energy product family, and it's a Bluetooth Low Energy 5.2 certified system on chip. It implements the following Bluetooth LE feature: high speed 2 megabit per second PHY for a faster data transfer, long range, it is what we are testing today, advertising extension, improved channel selection, and finally gut caching. This device has been added to our 10 years longevity commitment program, along with other Blue Energy devices among the product family. In particular, if we target the best range possible, we see that compared to the legacy 1 megabit per second physical layer, where we have a sensitivity of minus 97 dBm, when we make use of the coded PHY feature or the long range feature, we can go down to minus 104 dBm. This, jointly with a maximum output power of plus 8 dBm, gives us a dynamic range of 112 dB, so a very good range improvement compared to the legacy 1 megabit per second physical layer. There are now three physical layers within Bluetooth 5. The first one is, of course, the legacy physical layer that goes with the name LE1M, that is Gaussian frequency shift keying modulation with 1 mega symbol per second symbol rate. Then we have the LE2M, that is the 2 mega symbol per second physical layer for boosting the data rate. And finally, what is referred to in the specification as LE coded, that are two options. One goes with the name S2 and the other one with the name S8. Basically, here we scale down the data rate. With S2 we halve the data rate to 500 kilobit per second. With the S8 we go down to 1/8 data rate at 125 kilobit per second. Both of them implements forward error correction, and this allows the connection range to increase. All the physical layer besides the 1 megabit per second are optional from the standard. Our Blue Energy -LP device implements all these three optional features. In terms of evaluating the capability, you can refer to our evaluation board that is available and orderable. The part number is STEVAL-IDB011V1. This, besides the Blue Energy LP system on chip, also features various MEM sensor. You can plug it directly from USB programming, and also debugging from USB. There is full documentation available on our website, so I will encourage you to browse st.com/blueenergy-lp for additional information. We have within the SDK a dedicated demonstration for the long range feature. This goes with the name RC, that stands for Remote Control Long Range. So here you need two evaluation kits. One will be the client and the other one will be the server. You can power those boards directly from USB or from batteries. So first you need to download the SDK at this web address, and then once it's installed you can browse the start menu, the Windows start menu, and open the Blue Energy LP Navigator. The LP Navigator is a very simple PC interface that allows you out of the box to test the major feature of the Bluetooth low energy standard and of the Blue Energy Dash LP device. So here you go, you select the demonstration application, then you select the BLE demonstration and test applications button. This will point you to a list of possible demos that you can test. Now we select the BLE RC long range. And finally here you can select the client or the server role depending on which board you are programming. And once you have selected the role, you will find in the bottom right corner a button, flash and run. You hit this button and this will program the board. So now let's go and see how the demo will look like.
So here we are now with our two Blue Energy LP evaluation kit. One is here in my hand, and this will be the peripheral device working as a GATT server. On the table we have the central device configured as a GATT client. As soon as I will release the reset, the two boards will start, will connect to each other, and they will start communicating over the legacy 1 megabit per second physical layer. The client over there is sending write requests to our server, and those requests are notified visually by the red LED, the L3, blinking on the server side. So now we can switch the physical layer to the coded file by pressing the push one button. You will see the big blue LED on the board turned on both sides of the communication, so both on the server and on the client. And at this point we have switched to the coded file with the option S8 at 125 kilobit per second. Now I would like to recommend to use two AAA's battery on the bottom of the board for powering up the peripheral device. At this point, what you can do is, in a real-world use case, so in your office, outdoor, in line of sight, you can go around increasing the distance and checking which will be the range increase that the coded file will bring to your BLE communication. Enjoy your tests.